Hi, boys and girls. Welcome to Social Studies in the year 2021. We're going to continue our learning on North Carolina state history. And as you know, in a 9-week grading period, we'll do social studies for about 4 weeks, and then we'll do science for about 4 weeks. So to start off this year together in this new 9-week grading period, we're going to do about 4 or so weeks of social studies. And we're actually going to start with something that is my personal favorite thing to learn about North Carolina history. And as you can see on the screen here, that is called the Lost Colony of Roanoke. So let me kind of give you some background information here before we get started with our lesson. So recently in social studies, we have learned about men and women who once lived in England, but were very unhappy with the way they were being controlled. These people, they sought after many freedoms that we today may take for granted, like freedom of speech and freedom of religion. Many people left England and they traveled to the New World, which we now know as the Eastern region of the United States, which is the area that we live in. These people who left England are called settlers or colonists. They traveled by ship to the New World in an attempt to settle down and start over on new land. This didn't always go as planned for the settlers. The journey across the Atlantic Ocean was long and often very treacherous. The settlers were not prepared for the climates and weather conditions here in the New World. The communities that the settlers tried to create were called colonies, and not all colonies thrived and were successful. Many failed, and some people even died in their attempt to establish a new colony here in the New World. In North Carolina, there is a famous colony known for its mysterious history, and it's called the Lost Colony of Roanoke. Roanoke Island still exists today. It is in Dare County off the coast of North Carolina. You may be wondering, how can a colony full of people and everything they brought with them from England be lost? Well, we're going to start at the very beginning. The Lost Colony of Roanoke. So in the late 1500s, Sir Walter Raleigh wanted to establish a permanent colony in the New World. He gave John White the job of leading the expedition to the New World. So these two men here, whose names you just learned, Sir Walter Raleigh and John White, they are Englishmen. So that means that they lived in England. And Sir Walter Raleigh was actually a very well-known tobacco farmer in England. So both of these gentlemen were basically just working together, and they were going to lead this expedition, this journey to cross the Atlantic Ocean and arrive into what they called the New World, and they wanted to establish a permanent colony here, and the place where they landed was in North Carolina, and it was the Roanoke Island. So John White led a group of nearly 150 men, women, and children to the New World. And that ship that you're seeing there, that is a replica of the Elizabeth II sailing ship. So because it is a replica, that means it's kind of like a copycat of the actual ship that was used during this time period. After a long voyage across the Atlantic Ocean, the colonists anchored their ships off Roanoke Island on July 22, 1587. The Roanoke colonists immediately began repairing the houses that were left from a previous attempt to start a colony. So remember, we talked about how, not all colonies were successful. They didn't always thrive. The colonists weren't necessarily prepared for the climates here and the harsh weather conditions. So it's kind of like, imagine that you are packing your bags to go on a vacation or go on a trip somewhere, but you don't know where you're going. You don't know what the weather is like where you're going, and maybe you don't always know exactly how long you're going to be there. You don't know what materials and supplies you need to bring. You don't know what materials and supplies are already going to be at the place where you're going. So there was just a lot left to the imagination for these colonists. They didn't always know what to prepare for. So they were repairing houses that were left from a previous attempt to start a colony, but they were also building new houses. So you can imagine that takes a lot of building materials, a lot of different supplies that you're going to need, and stuff like that. So a short time later, on August 18th, John White's daughter gave birth to a baby girl named Virginia Dare. And just a little tip for you, the way that I remember her name, Virginia Dare, is that Roanoke Island is in Dare County, North Carolina. So Virginia Dare, Dare County, easy way to help remember her name. And she was the first English child born in the New World. And you definitely need to remember her name, Virginia Dare, and that she was the first child born in the New World. You're actually going to see a test question about that in the future. The Roanoke colonists begged John White to sail back to England and return with more supplies and colonists. So John White sailed back to England on August 27th, 1587. John White felt confident that the colonists would be fine during his short absence. However, he couldn't predict what would happen when he reached England. While John White was in England, war broke out between England and Spain. Every available ship was being used to fight the Spanish. Unfortunately for the Roanoke colonists, White was not able to return to Roanoke for 3 years. All right, so as you can imagine, you know, when John White returned to England, you know, he definitely wasn't expecting a war to break out. And so, you know, during this war, you know, when England and Spain were fighting with each other, he didn't have any ships to use. So if he didn't have an available ship, then there was no way that he could return back to the Roanoke colony. So, you know, you have to think about this time period. There are no cell phones. There are no, you know, email doesn't exist, you know, and stuff like that. So, you know, John White, he had no way to communicate with these colonists in North Carolina that he wasn't going to be able to return to them with the supplies that they had so desperately needed. So all the while, they're waiting on his return, wondering, where is he and what's taking so long? And is he ever going to come back? What happened? So, you know, if you put yourself in their shoes, you can imagine this was definitely a very difficult time to not only be in a new place, but also, you know, be waiting for these supplies that may or may not ever come. All right, so John White and a crew of men reached Roanoke on August 18th, 1590, on what should have been Virginia Dare's third birthday. So eventually, he was able to return to Roanoke, but it was several years later than what he had intended on. So when they got there, the men reported that the colony was abandoned. However, there were some clues left behind. What clues were left? Well, the word Croatoan was carved in a wooden post. The letters CRO were carved into a tree. The men reported that there was no sign of a struggle. So where are all of these colonists who came from England that were, you know, developing this colony on Roanoke Island? Where are they? Where did they go? What happened to them? These are questions that a lot of people still have unanswered, you know, including a lot of historians who have, you know, studied this event in North Carolina history for years now. And there's still a lot of questions that are left unanswered. So there are many theories that seek to explain the disappearance of the Roanoke settlers, and the following slides list five of the top theories. Now, I want you to listen very carefully here because I'm going to show you the five theories that historians have as to what may have happened to the Roanoke settlers, and this Thursday and Friday, your assignment is actually going to be to pick one of these theories and basically write a paragraph showing your opinion on this theory. So again, there's only five theories, and for your assignment at the end of this week, you will just pick one of the five theories. So you're going to have to make a decision here on which of the five theories you believe was probably the one that happened. Okay, so here we go. Theory number one, the missing Roanoke settlers grew desperate for food and supplies. Because remember, John White left to go back to England so he could bring them food and supplies, but then it took him 3 years due to the war with England and Spain, right? So during this time, the Roanoke settlers, some people believe that they grew desperate in their waiting for John White, and they felt that their best chance of survival was to abandon Roanoke and live with a friendly Croatoan Indians. So maybe that's why Croatoan was carved into a wooden post. Maybe the settlers were trying to send a message to John White on how he could find them should he return. I don't know. What do you think? Theory number two, the Roanoke settlers grew tired of waiting for John White to return. They set sail for England on their own, but were lost at sea. So this, in the past, when I've taught this lesson, has always been a very popular opinion amongst some fourth grade students, is that the settlers, they just decided, hey, you know, we're going to sail back to England on our own. And then they got lost at sea, or maybe their boat capsized and sunk with all the people aboard. You know, who knows? You kind of have to let your imagination wander a little bit here. Theory number three. At this time in history, England and Spain were at war. Perhaps the settlers were killed by Spanish troops marching up the coastline. Theory number four, the nearby Secotan Indians, and I think I said that right, Secotan, maybe I pronounced it incorrectly. The nearby Secotan Indians and the Roanoke settlers didn't get along. Could the Secotan Indians have invaded the Roanoke and killed the settlers? So this theory predicts that maybe the Roanoke settlers were attacked and possibly even killed by a Native American tribe. And last but not least, theory number five. Perhaps John White didn't tell the truth about what he found at Roanoke. He may have found the settlers deceased, and he and his men buried the bodies. He claimed the settlers had disappeared to avoid scaring future settlers away. So I don't know. It's all about which theory you believe in. Which one do you think is the most likely event that would have taken place? All right, so which theory do you think most likely explains what happened to the Roanoke settlers? That is the question that you're going to have to answer for your social studies assignment on Thursday and Friday. Now, for the other days this week leading up to this assignment, you are going to learn a lot more about the lost colony of Roanoke and Sir Walter Raleigh and John White. And so you've got more information coming to you this week that's going to help you make your opinion. But yeah, go ahead and be thinking about which theory that right now you most likely think explains what could have happened to these settlers. All right, boys and girls, and before I leave you, I do have a little video I want you guys to watch. Okay, so this is called the Roanoke Colony Song, and I have linked it here in your student assignment chart by itself. Click here for the Lost Colony Song if you want to listen to it again. So that way you can just listen to the song and you don't have to watch this entire video all over again. But if you've ever heard the song Let It Go, which was featured in the movie Frozen, then you already know the tune. It's just what this guy did was he put information about the Lost Colony of Roanoke to the tune of that song and kind of made like a little parody here. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and play, and I just want you to listen to this song because it's funny, but also the information in it is very, very good and accurate. All right, here we go. All right, guys, so this is where I leave you. And if you would like to listen to that song at any time and have just the song available to you, it is linked here for Monday, January 4th in the student assignment chart. All right, guys, have a good rest of your day. And as always, let me know if you have any questions.